Hello friends, how are you? I am back with another video. This is part 2 video of polysaccharides. In this video, we will discuss heteropolysaccharides, right? So, I will start with the definition of heteropolysaccharides. The polysaccharides composed of different sugar derivatives are known as heteropolysaccharides. So, the name can also be given heteroglycans or heteropolysaccharides, right? Hetero means they contain different groups, right? Now, coming on to the mucopolysaccharides, we'll start with their definition first. So what are mucopolysaccharides? They are a type of heteroglycans that contain repeating unit of sugar derivatives, right? Sugar derivatives can be amino sugars or uronic acid, right? Now coming on, they also contain some other groups as well, like acetylated amino groups, then carboxyl groups and sulfate groups, right? Because of the presence of these acetylated amino groups and carboxyl group, the pH of their these heteropolysaccharides and mucopolysaccharides become acidic. Hence, they are also known as acidic mucopolysaccharides. Now, coming on to the difference between mucopolysaccharides, mucoproteins and glycoproteins. So, first of all, I will define mucopolysaccharides. They are formed in combination with proteins and combination of protein and carbohydrate, right? So, the combination of protein and carbohydrate, mucoproteins, mucoids and proteoglycans. Now, mucoproteins contain greater than 5% of carbohydrates. The carbohydrate content can vary up to 90%. But in glycoproteins, the carbohydrate content is always less than 5%. So this is the major difference. In glycoprotein, carbohydrate content is less than 5%. And in mucoproteins, the carbohydrate content is always greater than 5%, but it can vary up to 90%, right? Now coming on to the mucoproteins, their function. They are components of tissue structure. And they also help in formation of extracellular space of tissue, cartilage, skin, tendons, and blood vessels. Ground substance in connective tissue is composed of glucosaminoglycans, right? Now coming on to the important mucopolysaccharides. These are number 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5. And we will remember them with the code H, C, H, D, and K, right? Though H stands for hyaluronic acid, C for chondroitin for sulfate, then again H for heparin and D for dermatan sulfate and K for keratin sulfate. The code is H, C, H, T and K. These are the five major mucopolysaccharides which we will discuss in this video. So coming starting with the first mucopolysaccharide from H, that is hyaluronic acid. Hyaluronic acid, now coming on, we'll discuss three aspects of each polysaccharide, heteropolysaccharide, that will be their location, their composition and their functions. So, first of all, the hyaluronic acid's location, it is found in ground substance in synovial fluids of joint and vitreous humor of eye, right? And it forms gel around the ovum as well. The composition is D-glucuronic acid and N-acetyl glucosamine. So, this is D-glucuronic acid and N-acetyl glucosamine. Now, coming on to the third part, that is functions. The functions include it acts as lubricant and shock absorber in joints. And it also helps in cell migration and it also helps in bone repair as well, right? Now coming on to the hyaluronidase, it is a enzyme that breaks beta 1 for linkages, right? So how is it useful? First of all, its concentration is found in high concentration in testes, seminal fluids and certain snake and insect venoms. And the hyaluronidase of semen plays an important role in fertilization because the enzyme clears the gel around the ovum that contains hyaluronic acid. So hyaluronidase breaks down hyaluronic acid around the ovum for the better penetration of sperm into the ovum. So it plays a role in fertilization. Now coming on to the third role which hyaluronidase plays, it that hyaluronidase of bacteria helps in invasion into the animal tissue as well. Now the second mucopolysaccharide, that is chondroitin sulfate. The code was H, C, H, D and K. The second C stands for H, C. C is chondroitin sulfate. It is structurally compared to hyaluronic acid, but the composition is D-glucuronic acid and N-acetyl galactosamine. So in the first mucopolysaccharide, we were having D-glucuronic acid, that was okay. But here it is galactose derivative, not glucose derivative. So this is the difference between hyaluronic acid and chondroitin sulfate. Now location, it is found in cartilage, bones, tendons, heart walls and cornea. The function, it plays an important role in maintenance in the shape and structure of bones and tendons. Now coming on to the third mucopolysaccharide, that is heparin, HCH. H for hyaluronic acid, C for chondroitin sulfate, now again H, it is for heparin. Heparin, location found in lungs, mast cell, blood and skin. Composition, it consists of N-sulfo, D-glucosamine 6-sulfate and glucuronate 2-sulfate, right? Now the function, the major function which is commonly known of heparin is, it acts as anticoagulant. Second, it helps in release of enzyme lipoprotein lipase, which helps in clearing the turbidity of lipemic plasma. And heparin is also used in suspected cases of intramuscular coagulation. So the third is clear, that is heparin. Now coming on to the fourth, that is H, C, H, D and K. So fourth is dermatan sulfate for D, right? The composition is L-hydronic acid and N-acetyl galactosamine. Again, the minor sugar is galactose. Galactosamine, and in place of D-glucuronic acid, we are having L-hydronic acid, right? Location, it is found in skin and heart walls. The function, it helps in structure and maintaining the structure and shape of the skin and heart walls. And beside this, dermatan sulfate is responsible for plaque formation in atherosclerosis, right? Now, coming on to the last H, C, H, D and K, last K is for keratin sulfate, right? It is a heterogeneous gas and it has a variable sulfate content, right? Beside this, it contains small amount of mannose, fructose and sialic acid as well. Now, coming on to the part 2, that is composition. It contains D-galactosamine and N-acetyl glucosamine 6-sulfate, right? So now coming on to the location, there are two types of keratin sulfate 1 and 2. 1 is found in cornea and 2 is found in cartilage. Both are C, but 1 is found in cornea and second is found in cartilage. Now the function of 1 keratin sulfate 1 is, it helps in maintaining the transparency of cornea, and 2, that is for cartilage, it helps in maintaining the shape of the cartilage. Now coming on to the next, that is agar. Its location, it is found in seaweeds, and beside this, it is a polymer that is composed of glucose and galactose sulfate, right? Now function, it serves as dietary fiber. Now this is agar. Now we're coming to agarose. Its composition is, in place of galactose sulfate and glucose, it contains galactose and anhydrogalactose, right? Now the function, it is that it helps in use in electrophoresis and also helping used in preparation of microbial culture, right? Now coming on to the last heteropolysaccharide, that is pectin. The composition is galactouronate and rhamnose, right? There are two functions. First is, it function as act as dietary fiber, and beside this, it is also used in preparation of jellies as well. Now these are the various books from which I prepared this lecture, like Satyanarayan, Harper's and Vasudevan. You can follow these books also. Now thanks a lot. Do like and subscribe my channel, and please bell button below. Thanks a lot, and I will be back with another video next week. Thank you.